It's possible to get unlucky using direct map caches, in that different blocks that are important to your application might get mapped to the same index in the cache. For instance, if an application happens to access two cache lines that have the same index, maybe this one and this one here, then they will constantly be evicting each other from the cache, and it will be essentially useless. This, of course, is rather silly, given that there are all these other entries in the cache that aren't getting used at all. The fundamental problem is that the address, any one of these here, is only associated with one location in the cache. We can mitigate these effects by associating an address with more than one block in the cache. One strategy is to treat all of the red lines as blue ones and all of the orange lines as green ones. If we do this, then we'll have twice as many places in the cache to store a blue line of memory. Actually, it's more convenient to think about the blue lines in the cache being together. And in this way, we can say that we have simply decided to ignore the most significant bit of our previous index, but to allow a cache block to now be stored in two possible places. Hence, this would be called a two-way associative cache. The downside is that we have to check two tags now to see if we have a cache hit, but we are less likely to run into the problem where we are constantly evicting the memory we need from the cache. If we decide this isn't good enough, we can halve the number of indices again to create a four-way associative cache. Returning to our general notation, we now say that we have 2 to the j associativity. This means that we only have 2 to the k minus j indices into our cache, and the index is really only k minus j bits long now. This greater associativity also gives the cache some choice about replacement. Whereas with the direct map cache, there was only one block in the cache where the data could be stored, we now have a set of possible locations, just 2 in our example, but maybe more. Typically, we choose to evict the entry that was least recently used.